She's our family. She's already a grandma, but she's still cute. Anyway, I placed the camera module in front of her, and I'm located about 3 meters away. How will it look on Raspberry Pi 02W? Let's try it through a share script. It will continue to try to connect until a connection is established, and the video will automatically play after the connection. Just 1 second. Here you are. The quality is good and shows the same quality as the dash cam used in cars. This transmits not only video but also audio data. Since the two devices are connected directly via Wi-Fi, there is no need for additional network. After connecting this from Raspberry Pi, you can receive regular video streaming through VLC player. Simple but pretty cool, isn't it? This is the housing shell of the AMB82-Mini board. This is simply a 3D printed one someone shared on GitHub. Also, since I don't have a 3D printer yet, I found the cheapest company to print it out, so I'm not sure about the material. I remember choosing the cheapest option. Also, when closing the front and back parts, magnets are used to close them. It seems to be very easy and quick to open and close. I think it's a good idea. Let me put them in each hole. The finished look is really good. It seems like a one-handed device and could be created more neatly if there was a space for battery inside, but I'm fully satisfied with this. Now let me put the camera module into the housing shell. Yeah, it's good. I like it. This is a device made using a long strip HDMI display and Raspberry Pi 02W. There is usually some space inside the monitor. By moving the position of the main board, I created space for my Raspberry Pi 0. Also, there is a small speaker installed on top of the Raspberry Pi board. Audio is output through this. This is the battery pack. Two 18650 batteries are included, currently using two 4000 mAh. Let's take a look at the camera module. It has two ports. One is the USB 2.0 host and the other one is for serial port. This also gets power by connecting to the power bank. Both the devices are running on batteries. This camera module works with Wi-Fi AP mode, waiting for other clients to connect. I have already set the SSID and password for Wi-Fi AP access in the code, so other clients can easily connect to this device through Wi-Fi authentication. This share script is to connect to Wi-Fi and play a video via RTSP with the VLC module. Since we already know our device's SSID and password, we can easily create a script for auto connection. This is how it works. Now it runs the Python script and output video and audio data using the VLC module. This is the same action as entering the RTSP URL in VLC player. When connecting a device for the first time, you need to use a root privilege or connect directly to Wi-Fi. The reason is that without a permission, new Wi-Fi connections are not acceptable at the code level. If you have Wi-Fi credentials, you can connect directly from the next connection without root privilege. Let's take a look at the battery consumption. In the case of AMB82, it seems to consume around 0.2 ampere when transmitting captured video and audio via Wi-Fi. In the case of Raspberry Pi 02W, it seems to consume around 1 ampere when driving the display and playing a video with Wi-Fi. When using a 3500 mAh battery, I think it's possible to use around 3 hours continuously. Also, you can use your mobile phone instead of a Raspberry Pi. Simple but very reasonable. This project is to create a camera streaming environment using battery-powered devices. even in an environment without a network. As long as the battery is connected, you can stream not only video but also audio data through its own Wi-Fi connection. I think this could be very useful. For instance, when you go camping, you can place your camera far away and detect external threats. Yeah, something like that. This is what this project is all about. You can refer to this project's source code on my GitHub. Alright, this is all I have today. See you on the next project.